On this episode of Splice Site, I talk with executive producer John Mankiewicz on how the show HouseMD handled rare disease stories. I'm your host, Daniel DeFabio.
Today, my guest is my former boss and old friend, writer and executive producer on shows like House of Cards, The Mentalist, The Marshal, HouseMD, which is specifically what we'll be discussing today. If you go back far enough, he wrote on Miami Vice. John Mankiewicz, it's great to have you here. Welcome to Splice Site.
It's good to be here.
What is the role of an executive producer in one-hour television?
Well, writers run television, basically. And so the creator of the show, or a sort of a couple upper-level writers on each staff, are executive producers. And we write the scripts, and we hire the directors, and we cast the shows.
On a show like HouseMD, medical diagnosis is sort of the whodunit. That's the kind of culminating point. Did an episode typically start with, this would be a good diagnosis, let's work backwards from that?
The Bertrand Rouchet book, we pretty much used for the first 7 or 8 episodes of House, of which Socratic Method was one. So there was a chapter about Wilson's disease in that book.
You wrote the episode, The Socratic Method, which the diagnosis at the end is Wilson disease, which is a copper transport disorder. And that's especially important to me because it's sort of the flip side of the disease my son had. So with Wilson's, you get too much copper. Mm-hmm. And with Mankiewicz disease, you get not enough copper. And I believe the kid in the show's name was Lucas, and my son was Lucas. So
that's right.
Coincidences abound. But I reached out to a friend of mine who's a filmmaker who made a film. She has Wilson, and she made a film on Wilson. And I asked her about the episode, Socratic Method.
John, a question that I had in watching the episode is the patient had both cirrhosis of the liver and liver cancer. And at the time of writing this, in the early 2000s, there was no link between Wilson disease and liver cancer. So my question is, was that a red herring, or what was the purpose in adding liver cancer to this character's profile?
I mean, in most, when you're writing fiction, sort of the rule is, you know, in a regular, in a non-medical fictional TV show, you can make up something that if it happened once, you feel comfortable dramatizing it that way. In the medical show, we were a little more rigorous, and it had to be the short answer to your question is, I think it was coincidental to it was a red herring, but it was definitely possible, according to the doctors, that the two could coexist.
I guess we should start treating her for Wilson's.
That's what I do.
In addition to good source material like the book and the article and the columnist, the show, I imagine, had a scientific advisor, a medical advisor that you could tap into when you needed?
We had a doctor on staff, David Foster, who had gone to Harvard Medical School and was practicing medicine. He would go back on weekends and work shifts at Brigham and Women's Hospital.
So in addition to the doctor on staff as a scientific advisor, medical advisor, were you or he ever reaching out to patient groups to get additional stories and information?
All the time. There was a, and I forget who we reached out to for Wilson's disease, but I do remember we were extremely concerned sort of more than we were about the quality of the scripts, that we didn't give wrong information, because we were all extremely aware that there are people who would be watching the show who might have the disease or know someone who did. And we didn't want to give anyone, sort of the way the federal government now is handling the pandemic. We didn't want to give anyone conflicting information or false hope from something that we were, that we made up and was wrong. We did, because it was a TV show, and I think it ran for 8 years. There were sometimes small things that we would make shortcuts on, but never anything that that was really integral to treatment of whatever disease we were talking about, we were writing about, we hoped.
Yeah. How long do you have to write an episode of House?
10 days to 2 weeks to come back with the first draft.
Right. So in those days on House, the shooting schedule might be how many days?
Eight. They're eight day shows. Yeah. Now we're in the golden age of TV. They're shot more like movies.
Right.
House of Cards, right. 10 days.
10 days for House of Cards to shoot. And how long do you get for post-production on an episode?
With House, we had to deliver, we were shooting an episode, doing posts on an episode, and prepping the next script all at the same time. So post generally probably had about 3 or 4 weeks tops before you had to deliver the episode.
The world of one-hour broadcast TV is probably as different as can be from a lot of our filmmakers who are, probably one person in a camera operations trying to make their awareness films. But can you think of any advice for those type of people from your experience that could benefit their experience?
You want to be prepared. You want to be as prepared as possible. I read an article about Robert Rodriguez, who said when he was making those movies, he would pick 7 props that he knew he had and write the script based on those 7 props. Which, you don't want your, you want to be able to know that you can tell your story with the tools you have. So we have a lot more tools, we have a lot of money in broadcast TV, much more than the guy you're talking about or woman making their, awareness, 15-minute awareness film.
I want to mention to you, I've said it before, but by way of thank you to you, early in the diagnosis of Lucas, having Menke's disease, my son, I mentioned that to you, and you mentioned one of Bob Dylan's kids was doing video work and I should check that out. And it turns out he was doing it for Global Genes. And I don't know, without that, maybe I wouldn't have found Global Genes and maybe I wouldn't started all these other things I do with rare diseases. Yeah, so it's your fault. You helped put me on this path. Yeah, but I noticed in that same episode, the Socratic Method, that's David Vey getting to slap himself in the face.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was very exciting. And David Vague was a friend of ours who worked in the office.
David and I overlapped there a little bit. Yeah.
I think David Shore thought of the slap, had wrote that part about to slap yourself in the face.
And you, that's the guy.
I I approved it strongly when I when we cast Vague. and if I recall, he was really good. He really
he was very good.
Himself pretty hard.
Do you have any great favorite behind the scenes stories from those days making House?
You know, and I know this from Hugh Laurie. People come up to him on the street and ask him serious medical questions. House was, and Hugh Laurie's character was so kind of ingrained in on broadcast TV, and people loved him so much that he still gets asked, you know, people come up to him and say, you know, my kid is sick and here's what the problem is. Do you have any ideas what it could be? Which is a little frightening.
Thank you, John, for joining me on Splice Site. Great to hear all about how House gets made and how medical dramas are a little different than others. Mm. Glad to have you. Thanks.
It's been a pleasure and it's great to see you.